So next, let's try a few variations on the face again. This time, we need to keep in mind that it's again a common pear shape. So let's draw these three lines across so that we have the proportions equivalent across these three lines. And now let's take the basic spear shape for the forehead and the jawline. Let's make it a bit precise. A same nose. We can try a few variations later. And let's try a new hairstyle, or maybe we can take something from the previous hairstyle. So now we need to keep in mind that we have to get the right attitude, and this character is going to be constant later on throughout the film. So we need to be very, very precise while we are making it. But don't stop trying. We have to keep on trying. And but I think the eyes are too wide in this situation. I would like to probably keep the eyes a bit closer. So let's try another version. Same pear shape. And this time, let's do a similar hairstyle, because I pretty much like the hairstyle right now. And let's try doing a variation. I think I like the hair, yeah. It's coming out much more neater. Now, let's do a bit of detail here and there. Make the jawline a bit more roundish, probably. Get in the collar a bit. Now, I'm making the eyes a bit close. Now, it adds a different attitude to this person. You know, it's, the cuteness comes across. The nose, I'm trying to make it a bit more curvy. Now, the expression is like a pouty face, which adds a different mood to this character. It'll make him much more innocent and worried and tense, and is always like a puzzled person. Let's try one more variation. We might get something very interesting. Again, this time I squeeze the head a bit more, have the jawline a bit more squeezed, and let's try a longer nose, probably. Now, if you see those three sketches, you can see a difference between the ages. The one which I'm drawing right now is much more younger, and I think I'm pretty much happy with this face. This is the most closest to the face which I want, probably. So I think this, we can work on the detail of it a bit more. I'm just shading the hair so that we get to know what sort of volume the hair contains. I think I'll finalize this. This would be the most closest sandy we can get.
So we have sandy from the front. Now let's try other views. We'll make a face chart of it. So
let's do some profiles of sandy. Just a face chart of Sandy. The front, the side, the back profile, which will help us draw a character later on. So detailing the same face again, having the hair in place, the expression similar, and this time it's frontal. We're gonna draw a front face, a side face, and a view from the back. So drawing those lines for reference so that the measurements are the same, the height of the nose, the distance between the eyes. So we take these lines a bit further and let's draw the side profile. Same spear shape all the time. Now keeping the pear shape in mind. Drawing the hair, how it looks from the side, plotting my nose in place, drawing the arc where it comes, the hair, how it's gonna look from the side, the ear where it's gonna be placed, the eyebrows, and then the eye and the mouth shape. Say the collar around the neck so that we know from where the shirt or the clothes start. Now let's draw the back from behind, how it's gonna look like, because there might be some shots which need sandy from behind. So the hairline, where does it end? Also the collar will be overlapping so that we know where the shoulders are gonna start from. Just detailing the outlines. So we have this rough three drawings in place, and let's do a small cleanup of it using a darker color. So now this is very quick. I'm just trying to know through my lines where what the volume is and removing all the scribbly lines, keeping just one single line to draw Sandy. This is much more easier. You can use a sketch pen to do it. You can use a sign pen to do it. You can use digitally. You can do it as I'm showing you right now. This is called as an inking or outlining the character. It helps you define the shapes and the forms pretty neatly. So like I didn't like the hair, which was going like a pointy hair. So I just know where the lines are supposed to be, smooth lines while I'm drawing the character. The eye definition, the pupil, the nose, and the curve that goes down to the chin. So we don't have a neck here. We are avoiding the neck because like it adds to the character, to the whole body, you know, the hunch sort of feel to Sandy. He's depressed, he's sad, so it'll add to the character. Doing the same for the from the back. So we have these three sketches ready, which will help us animate Sandy later, because we know how he looks from the front, from the side. Let's try a 3/4 profile too, similar way. This time the spear has more of a volume, this is very important because majority of the shots in your film, Sandy might not be exactly from front or side. So this time we're going to define how he's going to look from the 3/4. So this line that goes from the center of the head to the bottom of his chin is very important. And the eyes, the expressions, the volume of the nose, also the collar, how it goes around his neck, and a bit of expression.